Sup guys, Hokebird here, bringing you the Noob's Guide to Legendary for the 5th mission in the Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary Campaign, Assault on the Control Room.
This is as far as I can go! Roger that. We'll be able to find our way to the control center from here. Good luck! Fullhammer out!
Now this is one of only a few missions where you have to hit the ground running or you won't survive. So as soon as you gain control, toss all four of your frag grenades at the door as the elites come out, then jump in the shade turret to finish them off. There we go. There's going to be two of them, one blue, one red. As soon as all the elites are down, you can either stay in the shade turret or you can mop up the grunts with the assault rifle. And then as soon as all the grunts are dead, swap out the assault rifle for a plasma pistol. Sometimes you can catch this elite off guard, but it's more consistent if you just have a plasma pistol overcharge ready and then stick him with a grenade when you stun him. Sometimes the second elite will come out, and you might be able to EMP him and shoot him with a headshot, or you might have to wait. He might hang back and hide. Now, once both elites are down, you can just use the pistol against grunts. Try not to waste your pistol, because you need to make it last until you make it across the upcoming bridge. Once you clear the room and you come over to this exit door, there's going to be a bunch of grunts that come out. You shoot them in the head with a pistol. Shouldn't be a problem.
The Covenant presence here is stronger than I anticipated. They seem to have the entire region secured. Interesting. The weather patterns here seem natural, not artificial. I wonder if the ring's environment systems are malfunctioning. Or if the designers wanted the installation to have inclement weather.
This is Fireteam Zuna requesting immediate assistance from any UNSC forces. Does anyone copy? Over.
I didn't think there were any human forces left on this part of the ring.
Cortana to Fireteam Zulu. I read you. Fireteam Zulu, this is Cortana. Hold position. We're on our way.
Roger that. Make it quick.
I apologize for not demonstrating it here because I only figured it out after I had recorded this, but a better strategy here is going to be to hold an EMP shot in your plasma pistol and then rush down to the lower level of the bridge and take out the elite before he can really cause you any problems. As for the Banshee, which is the only other real threat in the area, the easiest way to take it out is going to be to get it to dive bomb you, and then as it passes overhead, stick it with a plasma grenade. You're going to have to work on your timing with that one, because usually you'll throw the grenade too late, so practice and you'll get it. Something that I tried that I found out was not an option is to jump into a shade turret to try to take down the Banshee, because then the Banshee will actually use the Banshee bomb, the fuel rod missile. And it'll either blow you up completely or knock you out of the shade turret and probably knock you off the bridge. So that's not an option. Alright, now down here on the lower level, there's going to be a bunch of sleeping grunts. Just tap them out.
Thank you.
That was probably not the best way to tackle that, because they'll pretty much all rush you once they figure out where you are. So a better way is going to be to handle this fight from the upper level and just pick off the grunts and jackals from a distance with your pistol. Again, if the jackals crouch down and use that shield for cover, use the EMP from the plasma pistol. Now, when you get a checkpoint, the doors are going to open, and out will come a bunch of grunts and a gold elite. If you pay attention, the gold elite is a non-issue. You saw I just killed him there using nothing but the plasma pistol. I didn't even use the EMP shot. Okay, this room is pretty simple. The only real threat is the one invisible elite, so what I like to do is chuck a grenade over there, stick the grunt, and sometimes he'll run over and take out the invisible elite in his panic. He didn't this time, which is good for me, because I get to demonstrate what you have to do when you don't get lucky. But you want to come over here and look for him, and a couple pistol shots should do it, because he doesn't have a shield. It only takes one headshot to kill him, but I recommend going for body shots anyway, since you should have plenty of ammo, and you're less likely to miss if you aim for the body. Now you can see there are a couple hunters over there that are creeping up on me, but really, unless they catch you off guard, they're a non-issue since you have the pistol. If you haven't figured out how to kill hunters by now, go back and watch the Truth and Reconciliation and my Silent Cartographer videos. Once you finish with the hunters, come over to this health and ammo pile, pick up the health pack if you need it, and pick up the pistol ammo, which we will definitely need, and then finish off the room.
Another! Here!
Enter the room, tap out the grunts. Once all the grunts are dead, you want to come over here to this corner. Sometimes you can stealth kill this elite, but it's kind of iffy, so I found that it was more reliable to just wait by the corner, let him see you, and then stick him with a grenade when he shouts at you. The rest of the room is pretty standard grunt and jackal clearing. Use the pistol headshots against grunts, and then the plasma pistol against jackals that are hiding behind their shields. Grenades work too, but you want to save your plasma grenades for outside, so don't go overboard. And if you can help it, don't use any of your frag grenades, because you can refresh your plasma grenades from dead grunts. You can't refresh your frag grenades. Okay, While this may not be the hardest fight in this mission, it's certainly my least favorite. Okay, so shoot the grunts in the shades, and then use your pistol and start shooting jackals from a distance. It's a total crapshoot whether you're going to kill them or not. And what you want to do is make your way over to this ghost. Stick the elite in his ghost. It really shouldn't be that difficult to do. Shoot jackals as you run, and what you want to do is make it to the ghost as quickly as possible and kill the grunts and jackals that are attacking the Marines. Now, here's the stupid thing. You want to immediately get out of your ghost and run over here to this health pack, sniper rifle, and rocket launcher, or else they will follow you out into the open and be killed by the plasma mortars from the tank. Now, once you get the Warthog, you want to come over here to these trees, park in here where you're kind of sheltered from the plasma mortars, and load up the Marines. Alright, that was about 10 things happening at once, but in case you missed it, I did pick up both the sniper rifle and the rocket launcher. And then the way you're going to do the rest of this is just clear the area with the Warthog. The technique I used in Reach to take down Wraiths, where I would stop moving, kind of park, and wait for the Wraith to shoot, does not apply here. The Warthog handles very differently, and it's so slow to get moving that that technique does not work. It will get you killed. So just keep moving, keep driving around in circles, and eventually the Marines will kill the Wraith. Something I feel I have to mention here is that it took me at least a dozen tries to get this result where I've got two Marines with nearly full health and a Warthog. Most of the time, the Marines are going to get killed by either grunts throwing plasma grenades, jackals with their plasma pistols, or just by the Wraith's plasma mortars, because they're not very bright. They go out in the open. So I think the point I'm trying to make is don't be discouraged if it takes you 10, 20, 30 tries to get this result where you actually have Marines in your Warthog. Once you clear everything up to here, I like to park and use the sniper rifle instead of the Warthog and not risk injuring myself or the Marines.
They didn't count on running into the biggest squad of Marine badasses in the Corps.
At this point, the only thing left is going to be jackals, so you can just splatter them all. This part coming up, I'm not a fan of this fight either because it's a total crapshoot whether the Marines will survive or not. What you need to do is jump out of the Warthog and get into the tank as quickly as possible. And if you save at least two of the Marines, you will have four Marines riding on your tank.
Punch it!
You especially want to save Johnson because he's got the sniper rifle.
Mira, a Mark V!
And of course, you're not done here. There's going to be more Covenant that come and attack you.
Got him!
So, keep your eyes open. There's going to be at least two ghosts and some assorted elites and jackals. But you're in a tank. This should not be hard. It certainly helps to know where the ghosts are going to come from. So there's going to be one that comes from this tunnel here that's straight in front of me, and another that comes from the pass over there on what was my left and is now basically straight in front of me. And it helps to shoot them from a distance, because once they get close enough, you're going to injure yourself and or your Marines if you try to shoot them too close.
More, over here!
See, there's one. So I'm trying to get away from it. And then I can shoot it.
Almost a man.
The area is secure. Get the hell out of here, man. Somebody call the dropship.
store that garbage right now, mister. You're a Marine, so act like it, damn it. We've got a job to do.
Negative, team. No evac available at this time. But the chief and I could use some assistance.
Okay, Marines. Time to pay back the chief for pulling your sorry tails out of the fire. Prepare to move out!
If you use the sniper rifle Let's or the go. Rocket launcher up to this point, you definitely want to come over here and grab full ammo for both, as well as a health pack if you need it. It's a real shame that you can't give the sniper rifle and the rocket launcher to the Marines, because that would really, really help if one of the Marines had the rocket launcher. But you can't, so we're going to make do. Okay, park the tank here and look at the hill and wait for the ghost. There he is. Shot.
Keep it up! Enemy mortar tank sighted at my position. Busy day.
The Covenant placed their tanks to defend the entrance to the tunnel.
Alright, then the next thing you want to do is come over here on this right side, over by where the tunnel lets out. Shoot the shade turret and the ghosts. Which is easier said than done, because the Scorpion is so inaccurate, it's really annoying. And then two shots to the Wraith should take it down.
Roger that!
That armor wasn't so tough after all! Let's mop up the rest of them!
Then you can easily mop up the three Jackals from over here. Just take advantage of the massive splash damage that the tank has. Your shot only has to be kind of close. Doesn't have to be right on. Then after the Jackals are dead, you want to come up here on this hill and see if you can see the Wraith above the tunnel over there. If you can't, don't worry about it. And then shoot the two shade turrets. Careful you don't drive too far forward and fall off the hill, because then you'll dump your Marines. And you might even probably, you know, splatter yourself. Alright, so the tank's down, shade turrets are down, there's gonna be one on that metal thing right above the tunnel. And that's where the poor accuracy of the tank is really noticeable, because it's surprisingly difficult to hit that shade turret from a distance. And then what you want to do is you want to drive over to this hill, look very closely. There it is, checkpoint. What's going to happen is a Banshee is going to spawn above and behind you. So you want to drive straight towards it and go under the fuel rod gun shot that it always fires and then shoot it once. And then all that's left is the Hunters, which is actually kind of tricky because despite being in a tank, you're not really armored up. You have great firepower, but not a lot of armor. So any shots that come your way are going to directly impact your shield and your health. So they can kind of sometimes combo you into oblivion with your fuel rod shots from a distance. So I like to either shoot them from a distance or get close and splatter them. This part isn't so much difficult as it is just tedious. If you don't already hate how inaccurate the Scorpion's shot is, you will after this fight, because there's a lot of long distance shooting that you have to do. Okay, so the primary threats in this area are going to be shade turrets, Jackals, and Hunters. Shade turrets are dealt with pretty easily, just blow them to oblivion with the tank. The Jackals are not so easy to deal with. You have to shoot them from far enough away that they won't shoot back, because you can't maneuver out of the way of that shot. If they fire at you, it will connect. So you have to fire from a far enough distance that they can't really shoot at you, and because you're firing from such far distance, you have to deal with the horrible accuracy of the Scorpion. Now, fortunately, you have infinite ammo for the tank.
Keep it up.
So, if you miss, not a big deal, as long as they don't fire back at you.
Like that.
And I'm trying to shoot the shade turret over here. Miss. Trying to maneuver.
Can't hide from me.
And I get shot at. So I got too close to the Jackal that time. And then you have two options. You can either stay in the Scorpion and do some long distance shooting across the chasm, but then you have to deal with the inaccuracy of the tank, or you can hop out and use your sniper rifle.
Aye, the bird! Oh, yeah!
And Johnson will help out with his sniper rifle as well. So if you want to turn the tank to give him a clear shot at the enemies across the chasm, he can then probably take out a couple of them. Maybe the Jackals, maybe the Elites, probably not the Hunters. They don't go down to the sniper rifle.
Roger that.
And then when you feel that you're ready, make your way across the bridge slowly.
Whoa.
Because you're going to have Jackals and more shade turrets shooting at you.
One alien down.
Nope, missed that shot.
Don't get cocky now.
I think I got that shot.
Trigger's down, man.
You can see Johnson, he just shot the Elite. I don't think he killed it, but he probably took its shields down. And I'm trying to be really careful here so that I don't get EMP'd by a Jackal or shot at by the Hunters. Because just like before, the Hunters will probably kill you if they start shooting at you because you're so slow in the big tank.
You make me proud, man.
This part's really easy. Just either run him over or shoot him with the tank. The only thing to watch out for is don't fire a shot too close to yourself or else you'll blow yourself up.
Covering fire.
And then shoot the Jackals on the hill. Easier said than done, but if you stay back, there's really no risk even if you miss. This is one of those fights that's just plain annoying. It's not really difficult, it just kind of highlights all the weaknesses of the game and how inaccurate the tank is. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is shoot the two ghosts. Then you want to make your way up and out of the tunnel quickly before the Covenant really shoot at you, especially the Jackals. They're going to be the ones that do the most damage with their EMP shot. Watch out for grunts with plasma grenades. That'll kill you instantly if you get stuck with a plasma grenade. This is really stupid. Miss. Jackal's still there. Miss again. The Jackal's still there. And then I got him the third time.
See that?
So that's why I hate the tank.
All right.
After everything's dead, you want to come over here to the left side first. Position yourself nicely and shoot the Covenant as they come out the door. It probably won't only take one shot on Legendary. On the lower difficulties, it'll probably only take one shot, but on Legendary, I'm almost positive you won't get them in one shot, ever. And then there's going to be a ghost back there. Shoot him before he can attack you. And repeat on the right side. Before you leave, what I like to do is hop out of the scorpion here. Hop on top of it, though that's not really necessary. Pull out my sniper rifle and shoot the grunt in the shade turret over there, because he's really hard to hit with the scorpion.
Floor it.
Same thing over here on the right side.
Keep it up.
There's a shade turret, and then Covenant are gonna come out the door and attack. Shoot them before they get out the door.
Hey.
And again, it's probably gonna take more than one shot. In fact, I can almost guarantee it's gonna take more than one shot. And then you'll know when you're done when the door is closed. And then what I like to do is shoot the tank from back here. One shot. And that's a miss. And the advantage of being back here is that he won't fire back, and now he's dead. And then come over here and pick up ammo for your sniper rifle and rocket launcher, as well as a health pack. I highly recommend stopping at that ammo pile. So that you're guaranteed to have full ammo for when you finally get out of the tank.
La Bamba!
When you approach this corner, two hunters are going to come out. You can either deal with them from a distance, though that's kind of risky. They have pretty impressive range on those fuel rod cannons.
Rot in hell!
And then what you want to do is go back and look for any stragglers, like elites over here, or this ghost, or what's going to be there every time is going to be a banshee, because it spawns with the hunters. You can usually find it in the back of the canyon, closer to the tunnel where you entered. Okay, the easiest way to do this part is to go up, fire and then immediately move back, because you will probably have a plasma grenade coming your way, and that will kill you instantly if it sticks to the tank. But then you can just mop them up.
You guys know. Bueno.
Once they're all down, you also want to shoot the two shade turrets across the canyon.
More over here.
There's gonna be one there that's gonna fire at you, and then the second one is over there. It's probably gonna be too far away to be able to see you. So take advantage of that and shoot it.
I thought the Covenant had eliminated all the Marine forces in this area.
Whoa! Anybody else hear that? Oh man, Covenant dropship inbound! Take cover!
The Covenant are dropping in behind us! We're trapped!
When you reach the bottom of the ramp here, you're gonna trigger a dropship to move into position. You can really just take them all out from down here. You don't even have to move the tank. And in fact, I would recommend not moving the tank, or else you'll probably run over the Marines. And then just shoot them as they come down the slope.
Eat it!
Lost contact.
Yeah, man!
Don't mess with us again.
Hey, that's the way to do it. All right.
And then once they're all dead, hop out of the tank and use your rocket launcher against the hunters. The reason you want to use the rocket launcher instead of the tank is because there's plenty of ammo for the rocket launcher, and you're more nimble on foot than you are in the tank. And then come over here. Grab ammo, don't touch the active camo. And then have your rocket launcher out and use it against this group of Covenant. There's going to be two invisible elites, a bunch of jackals, and a bunch of grunts. Just use the rocket launcher exclusively. There's plenty of ammo for it. If you feel you need to use your grenades, you can do that too, but it shouldn't be necessary. Once you clear them all out, come over here and grab the active camo.
Whoa, sir, the Covenant are dug in up in those rocks. They got us pinned down here.
We need to get up this ridge.
Marines, hold your positions. We'll handle those guns.
Master Chief, we should scale the ridge and get below the legendary guns.
I'm in no hurry. We're overcharged. Guns will shot us.
Alright, so as you can see, I just used the active camo to sneak up on the elites. Then once you pass a certain line, two ghosts, a banshee, and a couple of elites will attack you and your squad of marines. You can take out the ghost with the rocket launcher, the elite with the sniper rifle, and then the banshee with the rocket launcher. And unfortunately, once the marines are near death, they get super, super aggressive to the point of insanity, and they'll go out and basically kill themselves. Now, once the banshee dive bombs you, that's when you want to start to fire the rocket. Just like the grenade earlier on the bridge, where you grenaded the banshee down, you'll probably shoot your rocket too late until you get used to it. Then once the banshee's down, you can use the sniper rifle against the shade turrets, and then come over here to the middle. and there's going to be two elites down here. But these shouldn't be a problem, since you have a sniper rifle and Johnson has a sniper rifle.
I'm hit.
And then with them taken care of, then you can go over to the door where you exit the area. I'm trying to get the Marines to follow me there. Sometimes they're a little slow. There they come. I recommend you wait for the Marines, because they'll help you take down the two elites that come out the door. Anyway, have your rocket launcher ready, and as soon as the door opens, fire on the elites.
Cortana to Fire Team Zulu. I've sent a distress call tagged with your current position. Hold your position and await evac. The Master Chief and I are going to continue on ahead.
That's affirmative. Fire Team Zulu out.
Okay, and then the last thing you want to do before you leave the area is go back and pick up full ammo for your sniper rifle and your rocket launcher, as well as frag grenades and plasma grenades. You should all know this room. Sleeping grunts. Tap them out. Start over here on the right side and punch out all the grunts. As you move over to this side of the room, you want to be careful that you don't get spotted by the elites there. So you want to come up behind them. There's going to be usually one standing there. And then you can just hit the other one in the back. Then all that's left are the grunts, and they're all asleep, so you can just have fun. Punch them out. There's really no threat. At the top of this lift, there's going to be an orange jackal that meets you. Just hit him 3 times before he really gets a chance to fire. There's gonna be another one around this corner. Hit him 3 times again. Then toss a frag through the door to take out the other two. And now, ditch your sniper rifle and your rocket launcher in favor of a plasma pistol and a pistol, the elite combo. Because you don't want to waste your ammo on this little room. You're going to need it later. So, grenades are effective if you can place them. Otherwise, headshots. And of course, EMP the jackals if they're causing problems and avoiding your grenades. This corner works really well for cover. With the initial wave of grunts and jackals cleared out, you want to come over here to the left side. Sometimes there's going to be a jackal there, and sometimes you can stick him. That was kind of just me showing off. You don't have to do that. And then what you do want to do is look through this window and look for the gold elite. And then once he sees you, that's when the music's going to start. So you want to kill him probably from this window. No further up than this. If you can't find him, just fire at him a bunch of times and he'll seek out you. Alright, now once you move up, you're gonna pass an invisible line that causes an elite to spawn right where I'm looking. Just like that. Now usually he jumps down right where I'm pointing. Except he didn't this time, so just EMP him and plasma grenade him. And watch this. Boom. Red elite just spawned. So that's why you want to be extra careful when you're moving up, because sometimes the enemies will spawn behind you. Alright, and then there's also going to be one final wave that's going to come through the door where you're trying to exit. These jackals are actually the aggressive types of jackals, and they will charge this corner, actively trying to kill you, rather than taking up a defensive position. So you need to be on the defensive here, not so much offensive. Don't worry too much about losing too much health, because when you go back for the rocket launcher and the sniper rifle, you're gonna pick up the health pack. And then you can leave the room with full health and full ammo. When the music dies down, that's how you know everything's dead. So that's your cue to go back for a health pack, the rocket launcher, and the sniper rifle. Alright, start this bridge out, tapping out the 9 or so sleeping grunts. I was debating long and hard of whether to bring the rocket launcher or the pistol, because as is, you don't really have an effective weapon to kill the grunts on the opposite bridge, but if you don't bring the rocket launcher, you're gonna get mowed down by the invisible elites at the end of the bridge. And the pistol really isn't very good against them. I tried using the sniper rifle. You don't want to do that, or else you will run out of ammo, and you need it before you reach the next stash of ammo. So that's not an option either. So your options are either leave the rocket launcher and take a pistol, or you can use a plasma pistol. Lots and lots and lots of plasma pistol shots. And that's what I'm doing here. Near the middle of the bridge, you're going to see three red elites. Use the plasma pistol to knock out their shields and then shoot them with the sniper rifle. And if you find you're running low on plasma pistol ammo, you've got about 8 or 9 to choose from the grunts you tapped out earlier. This is just me trying to conserve my sniper rifle ammo a little bit. So I used a grenade instead. If you place it right, it can be just as effective. And then as you move up, you're going to encounter more jackals. Pretty much the same technique as before. You can also use these vertical kind of fins on the bridge for cover from the grunts on the far side of the bridge. They work great, or else you're gonna find yourself full of needles and exploding. As a rule of thumb, I would say you can use your sniper rifle against elites with no shields and jackals with no shields, but don't waste it on the grunts. And you can see how this would be much easier with a pistol. But if I brought the pistol, I couldn't have brought the rocket launcher. This is why I brought the rocket launcher. When you get to the end of the bridge over here, two invisible elites are going to come out the doors and attack you. So I'm running away like mad and trying to take as little damage to my shields as possible. And then I pick up the rocket launcher. Two rockets, two dead elites. And then here, I obviously don't want to use the sniper rifle or rocket launcher against grunts, so I'm looking for a plasma pistol to use. This part is tricky and requires a lot of patience. The goal here is to do the entire room completely stealthily. So when the elite turns away, run up behind him and melee him. Sometimes you can get unlucky and he'll see you coming. And then there's going to be another red elite over here. Avoid him. Watch your motion tracker. Wait till he walks away. And then run up behind him and melee him. Okay, two down, two to go. The other two, you're going to do the exact same way. Wait for the elite. Patiently. Like I said, requires a lot of patience. Alright, there he is, finally. So hide. Watch your motion tracker, wait for him to walk away, then run up behind him and melee him. And this was kind of stupid. I got lucky but unlucky here. Watch this. I kind of panicked and fired the rocket. Fortunately, there's a health pack here. But I'm still kind of pissed that I had to use the rocket. Anyway, this ammo pile is going to be your lifesaver. Ditch the rocket launcher and the sniper rifle, and pick up a pistol and an assault rifle. And you're going to swap out the assault rifle as soon as you get your hands on a plasma pistol. So this is why there weren't any grunts and jackals in this other room. They were all waiting out here. This is pretty simple. Shoot grunts with headshots, and shoot jackals with either headshots or the EMP and then headshots. Sometimes you can stealth kill this elite, but I decided not to this time. Alright, so once he walks away, run over here to the right side and tap out the grunts. Be careful as you get closer to the door because there's jackals over here. Alright, time to end the silence. Alright, so now they know you're here. You can grenade the jackals, that should be pretty effective. And then the elites are gonna come running. I recommend grenades instead of the pistol because it's just faster. Especially if you miss with the pistol. That was really close. I almost got myself surrounded. Thank goodness the grunt just wanted to run over there instead of actually shooting at me. Once you're finished with the edges of the room, it's time to tackle the center of the room. So, come in here, see if you can spot an elite, try to stick him. I didn't even come close there, but what's gonna happen is they're going to come down the ramp looking for you, and that's how you ambush them and stick them.
Not again! Back up!
There we go, that's what I was waiting for. Alright, that's one elite. I think there's two more red ones. Too bad I'm out of plasma grenades there. I just bounced a frag grenade off the back of his helmet. So if you run out of plasma grenades, you can either scavenge some from dead grunts, or if you can't get that to work for you, you can use the EMP and then pistol headshot. Alright, so I've got a little trick for this bridge. We're gonna do some backtracking here. Because ordinarily the hunters on that far bridge are really annoying. So what we're gonna do is first we're gonna try to take one of them out without them noticing. You're gonna see in a few seconds here, I do not succeed at that. The jackal sees me. So what we're gonna do instead is we are gonna do some backtracking. Because that is the bridge we just came from. So you can run back here through these rooms and end up on that bridge. Watch this. It's a little time consuming, but I think it's worth it. Considering what your alternatives are. As you run by this ammo pile from before, pick up your sniper rifle. And stay back here where you're covered by that glass window from the jackals shooting at you. Just be careful that you don't get blown up by the hunter. So let him see you, and he'll come attack you. Then shoot him in the belly with a pistol. Then as for the other one, same thing. Let him see you so that he knows where you are. There he is. I don't know if he's seen me or not. Well, now he's seen me. Careful. Don't let yourself get blown up. And then shoot him in the belly. There we go. Now the hunters are down. And because you picked up your sniper rifle, you can take out the elites on the far bridge from here. And you can also try to grenade the jackals like so. That can be pretty effective, but you only have so many grenades, you won't get them all. So as you move out of cover, they'll move with you. So just shoot them in the head as best you can. Don't use your sniper rifle, you don't want to waste it. Then as soon as you can't see anything else to kill, head back through the door and make your way over to the bridge. As you come by this ammo stash again, now swap out your pistol for the rocket launcher. You should now have a sniper rifle with full ammo and a rocket launcher with full ammo. Just because the bridge looks clear now doesn't mean it actually is. There's going to be more red elites and more jackals that are going to spawn. Take them out with a sniper rifle. Shouldn't be a problem. If he slips into cover, you can use the rocket launcher. Now you can use the sniper rifle a little more than before, because now you're not conserving it nearly as much. Same thing with the rocket launcher. You're just saving the rocket launcher for the two invisible elites. So, start with some grenades. There they go. And the bridge is clear. You can feel free to use your sniper rifle and rocket launcher in this room, but save at least 3 or 4 rockets for the invisible elites in the next hallway. So I start by ignoring the jackals and tapping out the grunts. There's no elites in this room, they're all in the next hallway. Alright, so your cover's blown. They're gonna come running. If you're gonna use the rocket launcher, at least make sure you get 2 with 1 shot. Unless, of course, he's standing there ready to EMP you. I would call that enough of an emergency to use the rocket on him. But now, here we go, I've swapped it out. That's the easiest way to conserve the rockets, is to not be able to use them. And you should be able to take out the grunts and jackals over here with just a plasma pistol and grenades. You'll know everything's dead once that music starts, so ditch your plasma pistol and pick your rocket launcher back up. Have your rocket launcher ready, aim, and fire. I just got 2 of them, including the one with the sword. And then there's going to be 2 more, both with plasma rifles. There goes one. Only 1 left. And 2 rockets to kill him with. And there he goes. Now one of the tricks I have here is that there's an active camo over here. Save it for later. There's going to be 2 hunters in this room. You can either use your sniper rifle, or you can pick up a pistol.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
You can pick up a health pack if you need it, but more importantly is the ammo for the pistol and the sniper rifle. So what you want to do is come over here to this door. There's going to be a bunch of jackals and a bunch of grunts. Just shoot them all in the head.
Increasing. We must be close to the control center.
Alright, here's the trick to make the next fight a lot easier. Head back into this room, pick up pistol ammo and sniper rifle ammo. The sniper rifle is going to be up here. And then go back for the active camo. Grab the active camo and run. You'll see I don't do anything tricky here. I don't do any trick jumps, grenade jumps, anything like that. I just run, and you'll make it.
Analyzing. This must be the control room. Subtle. The entrance to the control center is at the top of that pyramid structure. Bring me up there and I should be able to get us inside.
Alright, so ordinarily this would probably be the hardest fight in the mission. But with the Banshee, it's probably only the second hardest. So, first shoot down the other Banshee. And then next, you want to focus on the elites and the jackals on the natural bridge. Because the elites are what's going to wear down the Banshee the quickest with that plasma rifle. There goes one. There's the other one. There goes the second one. Alright. Now you can focus on the grunts and jackals. And Halo 1 is unique in that if you hold backwards on your movement thumbstick, the Banshee will just kind of hover in the air. You can't do that in any of the other Halo games. Once you clear all the enemies off of the bridge, you want to focus on the Wraith. It takes a lot of Banshee bombs to take down the Wraith. Pretty effective strategy is to circle around these trees as you're dive bombing the Wraith, and usually if the shot comes anywhere near you, it's going to hit the tree and not you. Just watch your elevation, because if you get down too low to the ground, the ghosts will actually shoot at you. They'll kill you actually pretty quick.
Thank you.
There we go, now the tank's down. Now, you want to use the complete opposite strategy on the ghosts, because if you banshee bomb them, you knock out the elite, he will shoot you down in a matter of seconds with his plasma rifle. So you want to use the plasma cannons on the banshee instead of the banshee bomb to either shoot the elites out of the ghost or just destroy the ghost entirely. And here is a bit of indecision at its finest. I decided maybe I could land and do this on foot, and then I said no. This would actually be easier. I've got more firepower in the Banshee. And then I realized that if the hunters hit me, I have to do this all over again. I'd rather not do that. So I kind of compromise with myself, and I say, okay, I'm just going to take out the grunts, and then I'm going to take care of the hunters on foot. So I certainly hope you have a pistol and not a rocket launcher.
Another! Here!
You'll find this room a lot easier with the pistol instead of the rocket launcher. There aren't any elites in this room, so pretty standard stuff at this point. Shoot grunts in the head, use grenades against large groups of enemies if they are overwhelming you. And feel free to drop the sniper for a plasma pistol to take care of the jackals. Pretty standard stuff by now. The only really notable thing about this room is that there's going to be a bunch of jackals over here by the exit, and they'll almost all be holding the EMP shot ready for you, so just grenade them. There's two invisible elites in this room. You might be able to punch them out. If not, just grenade them and then use the pistol. Once again, shouldn't be a problem since they don't have any shields. Now, of course, that means that you'll make noise and the rest of the grunts and jackals in the room will know that you're there. But at this point, there should be nothing here that you can't handle. This is really just standard room clearing of grunts and jackals. There's all kinds of ammo up here, pistol, rocket launcher, sniper rifle, frag grenades, even assault rifle.
Center is located at the top of the pyramid. Let's get up there. We should come
now because you
ghosts,
used the banshee to kill the wraith and the ghosts and the elites that would be patrolling and would spot you. The grunts in here are asleep, and this is a unique encounter in the game. The hunters here are asleep. You can walk up to him, stand right in front of him. Hi, Mr. Hunter, how you doing? He's asleep, he won't see you. Same with the one over here. You walk in front of him, wave hi. Nope, he's asleep. Sweet dreams. Then after the hunters are dead, you want to walk down the ramp and go get yourself a ghost. Apparently that little guy was still alive. Anyway, not one of these ghosts. These are the ghosts that I shot the shit out of with the banshee. See, it's got red health. You want the fresh ghost over here. There we go, full health. Then what I like to do is I hop out of the ghost when I'm taking out the shade turrets, because the shade turrets will wear down the health on the ghost very, very quickly. But then I use the ghost to take out grunts and elites. The nice thing about Halo 1 is that grenades and weapons fire will only do damage to the ghost if you're actually in the ghost. So if you bail out of the ghost when you're taking fire, you'll keep it alive much longer. Plasma cannons on the ghost kind of stun elites. You should be able to take them down without any problems. Same thing here as before. Use the sniper rifle against the shade turret and, just for fun, the other grunt. And then hop in the ghost and deal with the rest. Or bail out if you're taking a lot of fire from the jackals. That works too. Thank you. When jackals see you coming, they can really wear down the health on your ghost, so I tried to snipe this guy here. Failed miserably. But since he ducked into cover, I figured I could move up on him with the ghost and take him out before he could do a whole lot of damage. Up here, you just want to use the ghost against the grunts in the shade turrets and pretty much any grunts that don't really notice you. Once they start shooting at you, you need to bail out or else they'll wear it down pretty quick. And especially the hunters. You don't want to be in the ghost to face the hunters. That's a one-shot kill. I'm going to go ahead and assume that no explanation is necessary at this point. You should know how to kill hunters. As soon as you hit the button, you immediately want to fall back and use this ramp as cover. Then pull out your pistol and start shooting grunts. When the gold elite with the sword comes anywhere near you, pop in the ghost and shoot at him. It stuns him pretty good. So there he is. I'm trying to get him to charge me down by provoking him by shooting him. Careful of the other grunts, because they'll wear down the ghost. He didn't stand a chance. Alright, as soon as the elite's down, feel free to bail out of your ghost and take out the grunts on foot with the pistol. And there's going to be two elites back there that'll probably take cover around the corner. You might be able to get them with the sniper rifle, but probably not. So what I like to do instead is just charge them down with the ghost. Hit the button to end the mission.
This is it, Halo's control center. Try there.
You all right?
Never been better.
You can't imagine the wealth of information. The knowledge, so much, so fast. It's glorious.
So, what sort of weapon is it?
What are you talking about?
Let's stay focused. Halo, how do we use it against the Covenant?
This ring isn't a cudgel, you barbarian. It's something else. Something much more important. The Covenant were right. This ring, its forerunner,
Give me a second to exit. Yes, the Forerunner built this place, what they called a fortress world, in order to... Wait. No, that can't be. Oh, those Covenant fools. They must have known. There must have been signs.
Slow down. You're losing me.
The Covenant found something. Buried in this ring. Something horrible. And now, they're afraid.
Something buried? Where?
The Captain. We've got to stop the Captain.
Keys?
Weapons cache he's looking for. It's not really... We can't let him get inside.
I don't understand.
There's no time. Get out of here. Find Keys. Stop him. Before it's too late!